learning a lot more about a DeKalb County teacher accused of murder, and police confirm he's a member of a dangerous gang. So what was he doing in a classroom filled with children?
1,500 meals destroyed by chemicals and flames. How the community stepped up to fill the need.
Tons and tons of guns, some small, some pretty large, carted out in court today. And Tex MacGyver says he's not really a gun guy.
He's being called a hero tonight. How a North Georgia man used social media to help rescue a 15-year-old girl.
I'm Natisha Lance. First tonight, we're starting off with some breaking news surrounding the popular high school football coach accused of sexual battery and assault. Here's what we know. 37-year-old Brad Elliott is a teacher and receivers coach at Buford High School in Gwinnett County. Police say he touched one student inappropriately and had consensual sexual contact with another, which is still illegal since he is a teacher. Police just telling us now in the last hour that Elliott has turned himself in and has resigned from Buford High School. He previously taught at Roswell High School. No word tonight yet from police if there are any other victims at that school.
All right, thank you, Natisha. We're learning disturbing new details tonight about the DeKalb County elementary school teacher arrested for killing two children. We now have the arrest warrant for Michael White, and it confirms he's also allegedly a member of the Rolling 20s Crips gang. White was arrested Friday for the shooting deaths of 11-year-old Tatiana Coates and 15-year-old Davion Coates in Clayton County. School officials say White passed not one, but two background checks last year before he was hired and later promoted at Tony Elementary School. Now, many of you are reacting to this shocking news on social media. Gladys says, sorry to say, but that's what's done in the dark will always come to light. No remorse for those kids he killed, and living on like nothing happened is a big red flag. Laura says, wow, whatever happened to background checks and references, interviewing neighbors, fingerprints, and checking their Facebook posts and Facebook friends. Rebecca says, don't know what to say. It sounds strange. I hope they get to the bottom of the real truth. Well, tonight, Ron Jones is digging deeper into the story. Went back to a neighborhood where parents are still trying to process what happened.
You know, my objective for this story this evening was to return back to the neighborhood not too far from Tony Elementary School, because I really wanted to hear from the hearts of the parents, especially those parents who have children that attend that school. Spoke with a lot of people, but this one young mom in particular had some interesting things to say. She said she didn't even know about the arrest, or at least the allegations against that fifth grade teacher. Listen to this.
I don't know, just how did it happen?
Carissa Henderson's son attends Tony Elementary School. Her little boy, Loyal, saw the police at school the day of the arrest, and he had questions.
What did he do?
Carissa, like many concerned parents, have questions too. How was a teacher, a confirmed dangerous gang member, able to allegedly fool administrators, teachers, students, and even parents for so long? She doesn't know who to trust now.
I just know that people are very good at manipulating. It's a career for some people. And I know some people, that's who they are, is pretending to be other people. So I don't know what to think of it.
Unbelievable. You know, really on the surface, we should all be shocked, or should we be shocked by the fact that you've got an alleged gang member with a day job as a teacher?
Absolutely. We should be shocked, just like Carissa was shocked. But no, we actually spoke with a former gang member tonight. Listen to this. Art Powell is currently a life coach who works with the City of Atlanta and his Centers of Hope. And today, he cautions young people about the dangers of gangs and crime. But at one point, he ran the streets as part of the I Refuse Posse. Now, Powell says if it's true this teacher actually was involved in this activity, he's not surprised.
Gangs are very sophisticated, and they've intentionally implanted and infiltrated government agencies, law enforcement, the military, and school systems for the purpose of, you know, having somebody in those environments to keep them abreast of what's going on as they try to, you know, continue to evolve and grow.
Now listen to this. According to warrants, police say Michael Deshaun White was a Crip, specifically a member of the Rolling 20s. It's the second largest African-American street gang, and members have tattoos of the Pittsburgh Steelers emblem. Now White is listed in the warrant as a shooter. That's someone you rely on to shoot someone else. That person often carries firearms.
All right, let's say he is a gang member here. he has the ability to really influence an entire classroom of young children.
Absolutely, which is not shocking to a lot of folks, and it's very likely that was taking place. This is according to Powell. Powell says it's very easy for a gang member who is a teacher or a coach to recruit future members.
That's what's captivating these young people, you know, particularly young people that are coming from homes where there's a lot of negligence and, you know, the parents are busy all the time and they're not really showing them any support. The kids are drawn to this buy-in that the gangs are selling, saying, we love you, we support you, we got your back.
That's interesting insight from a guy. He really knows what he's talking about.
He really knows what he's talking about, you know, because he was in jail for at least a decade. He got out of that gang life. He totally changed all of that, folks. He's turned his life around, and he's now teaching our youth to avoid the mistakes he made in the past.
All right. Thanks so much, Ron. Important story tonight. Really is. Right now on 11alive.com, we have an explainer on some of the gang terms used in these arrest warrants. You'll also get a full history of the case, including reaction from the neighborhood where that shooting took place. A family is reunited tonight thanks to Snapchat and a user being hailed as a hero for rescuing a 15-year-old girl. Ryan Krueger's been tracking this story for us. And Ryan, you spoke with the man who actually helped capture the suspect here.
Yeah, that's right. Now, he says he did what any father would do. And tonight, that missing girl, thankfully, back home safe and sound. Let's start with the backstory here. 15-year-old Amber Austin disappeared from her grandmother's house back on Saturday night. No one knew where she was, hadn't seen her in several days. And then this morning, 27-year-old Dakota Moss, he's a family friend. He actually saw Amber in a Snapchat photo. So he decided to take matters into his own hands. He got on social media himself. He was pretending to be a woman, hoping to entice the suspect to come to his house. I spoke with him this evening over video chat, and he describes what happened next.
When he had pulled in, he had went around to the back, and I had my roommate meet him at the back, and I went out the front door, and I had called the sheriff's department and let them know, hey, he was here, and she was in the back of the SUV. When I saw her in the back of the SUV and I opened the door and I got her out, she did have a bandana tied around her wrist, so I'm not sure if maybe he abducted her or how that could have went. I'm not really sure. She seemed scared. She was real scared. She had tears in her eyes. You know, and she just seemed pretty upset about the situation. Because I prayed so hard last night that God would help me find this girl. And, you know, it all worked out for the best.
And she is back home, thankfully. Now, the suspect in this case is 34-year-old Dayton Coop. Authorities tell us they also found meth on him. And he's charged with the unruliness of a minor. He is being held tonight in the Gordon County Jail.
Well, another big shakeup at the White House. That is where we're starting our speed feed tonight. President Trump has fired the head of Veteran Affairs, David Shulkin, in favor of his personal White House doctor, Admiral Ronnie Jackson. Trump used his favorite outlet, Twitter, to announce that change. Dr. Jackson has served as the personal physician to the past three presidents. Shulkin is the second cabinet secretary to be fired over reports of personal travel on taxpayer dollars after Health and Human Services Secretary Tom Price. A 60-year-old man is accused of using the Whisper app to lure a child to meet him. Cherokee County deputies say Thomas Ward of Kennesaw is a traveler or someone who goes to a different city to meet kids for sex or other indecent acts. He was arrested today outside a roller rink in Woodstock. Now he's charged with 6 counts of obscene contact with a child. Tonight, a geyser in Northwest Atlanta is gone. Crews are just finishing up repairs at the intersection of Northside Parkway and West Paces Ferry. A fallen tree busted a water main there this afternoon, sending water shooting so high into the air, drivers could see it all the way from I-75. Thankfully, nobody was hurt, but almost 2 dozen homes and businesses did lose water service for about several hours this afternoon.
All right, getting ready for some nasty weather, maybe?
You know, we're watching these storms that are just out to the west. Vinny, I want to show you where they are right now. We are fine here in Atlanta, but I want to take you over just a couple of states over. And look at this. You can see these storms that have been moving through Mississippi. There's a tornado watch left. But, Vinny, earlier this was prompting numerous severe thunderstorm warnings and tornado warnings. The good news is this is showing signs of weakening as it moves into Alabama. And we expect it to be a little weaker toward when it gets into our area later tomorrow.
But it is coming.
There is is a chance. We're definitely going to have some rain and maybe some thunder and lightning with it, but there's a slim chance for some severe weather. In fact, let me break that down for you right now. Let me show you the bigger picture, and you can see here what we're watching tonight. That severe weather risk is over in Mississippi, where you're seeing those storms right now. It'll weaken when it moves into the Alabama area. However, tomorrow, as the system gets closer to us, I expect it to fire up again in Alabama, where they have a slight risk for severe storms. That's number 2 out of 5 categories, 2 of the 5 categories there showing that risk. And then we're in the dark green color, which is the marginal risk, which is the 1st out of 5 severe weather categories. What that means for us is we have the potential for a few isolated stronger thunderstorms. The main threats with this system would be some damaging winds, maybe an isolated tornado or two. Stay with us. I'm going to break down the timing of this with our forecast track. I'll show that to you in just a bit.
A church's plans to feed thousands of kids over spring break up in smoke. Why this arson isn't destroying their good work.
A Howard University employee accused of traveling the world, treating himself, funded by students' financial aid.
Hey guys, Alicia Vikander is here teaching a new Swedish game. Plus we have Jim Sturgis, music from Kali Uchis, featuring Tyler, the Creator. Stay tuned.